Bill Sienas had box seats to game four of the 45 World Series, Cubs against Detroit. One seat he would sit in, the other was for his kid, a goat by the name of Murphy, who the Cubs always had admitted. That day, Nusher would not let them to their box in Wrigley Field, so directly to the owner, P.K. Wrigley, he appealed. The answer came from Wrigley, it was final and succinct. Said there'd been a few complaints, some people didn't like the stink. Lucianus, he was livid, and his face was turning blue. He went out past the turnstiles onto Waveland Avenue. The vendors on the sidewalk say he raised his arms up first, and with his hands above his head, they say he placed the curse. And just then a cloud passed over from the lake, a chilly wind, and anybody with an earshot would have had goosebumps on their skin. Skeptics say baloney, poets make a verse, 60 some years later they still blame it on the curse. Those two box seats bore witness as the Tigers took the game, like they would games 5 and 7, the Cubbies come out lame. Old Billy Goldsianus got the last word, holy cow. He telegrammed Mr. Wrigley and he asked him who smells now. It stared at Leo DeRocher, stared right at his lip. Leo stood there staring back with his hands upon his hips. On the top step of the dugout, cat the color of a hearse, they blew a 9-game lead in 69. People say it was the curse. Well, they were playing for the pennant in 1984. Against the San Diego Padres, only had to win one more to advance to the World Series. But they slipped into reverse, first baseman flubbed the grounder. People blame it on the curse. Well, they say cloud passed over from the lake, a chilly wind. Anybody with an earshot would have had goosebumps in their skin. Skeptics say it's hoo-ha, the poets make a verse, 60-some years later, they still blame it on the curse. Most recently, 2003, and just 5 outs away, when a Cubs fan tried to catch a foul while the ball was still in play. The lockers had been plasticized, but the bubble had just burst. The Marlins drank the champagne, people blame it on the curse. So just ask someone in Boston how long it took to break the curse of the Bambino with a annual heartache. Every time it happens, well, it just feels that much worse. They say there's always next year, well, that might be the curse. Well, they say a cloud passed over from the lake, chilly wind. Anybody within earshot would have had goosebumps on their skin. Skeptics say baloney, the poets make a verse, 60 some years later, they still blame it on the curse.